Welcome to African Free Press Studio, and this is On Point. My name is Ekene Ezepue, and we want to talk about the closure of Abuja International Airport, and that's why we prepared a feature as we went to the street to get the views of the people. So, enjoy.
The federal government has formally announced the closure of Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, beginning from 12 p.m. Wednesday. This was announced by Minister of Information, Mr. Lai Mohammed. Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, has been there for years, and from the look of things, the airport is about to undergo a total maintenance and rehabilitation that will make it to possess one of the best in technological and infrastructural facilities. When the AFP news crew interviewed some of the Abuja residents, this is what they have to say.
Well, just like any other rational person will feel, if the government feels that there is need for the saving of human lives, I don't think there is anything, even if they are going to close for more than that, irrespective of the economic gain or losses we are getting, let them do that.
We just have to bear with the situation. There is no country that is perfect. People, how many people do have access to the airport before? It is only the big men. They will be the one to feel the heat. If it's in the country where things are done properly, I don't think this should be something that is something that we will say is a serious issue, because there are some countries where it's not as half of Nigeria. The neighboring cities have quality airport that people can easily use for whatever reason. But the most annoying part of it is an international airport like Abuja, the federal capital of Nigeria, should not be witnessing this type of situation, because it makes a lot of meaning to the international community. But be as it may, if it has come, we have to bear the pains, because it's for the good of all of us, and we quite appreciate the government that they want to put certain things in place for the development of this great nation. We are still a developing countries where things are in the gradual process, and we should learn to agree that yes, what we are seeing in Europe, Americans, is what we want to replicate, but we don't have it yet.
And this is where we draw the curtain on today's program. Till I come your way next week, my name still remains Ekene Ezepue. Remain blessed.